I'm with Anthony David Gatt. Anthony, can you tell us what your field of work is?
Hi, Becca. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. I am an investment promotion manager at Malta Enterprise.
And why are you at the summit today? What have you been involved in so far?
So basically, there are two elements. The first element is that Malta Enterprise has effectively sponsored the Startup Village, which is all these mini booths that you can see all through the three stories of the event at the Hilton, where alongside the Malta Chamber of Commerce and also the organizers of the Malta AI Blockchain Summit, we decided to give an opportunity for startups from all over the world to be here, maybe to make it more accessible to them, so giving them tickets inside this arena, to exhibit their project, their business plan, their idea, and hopefully the summit acting as a space for them to meet new contacts, employers, employees, potential financiers, you know, actually effectively taking as much as possible out of such a strong event, which has both quantity and quality.
Yeah. And of course, there's been such a positive vibe in these past 2 days, but what can you tell me you feel are two main challenges that startups in either blockchain or AI face when they come to Malta?
So, the advantages are clear, right? The advantages are the regulation, the jurisdiction, the fact that we are forming a proper ecosystem, so it's not just an operator or an exchange or a wallet or a corporate service advisor, but it's all of them together that are being encapsulated in this little island with a big vision. From our point of view as Malta Enterprise, what we do is support with other elements, our incentives, our support measures, that are concentrated on both making sure that companies that have a quality proposition get the right kind of finances. So we have startup assistance, which can go up to €200,000 as a loan, for example, but also to address a number of other challenges, as you referred to in your question. So maybe one challenge is obviously talent and the training of the talent. So when it comes to talent, the country has already a very good offering as per talent pool. However, being small and also because of the fact that software developers and mathematicians are they're sought after not just in Malta but all over the world, we try and assist the companies that come to Malta in order for them to recruit both locally but also internationally. So if these companies want to bring someone for their C-suite, for their management, that would be earning a good wage of upwards than €45,000 a year, we would be able to help those individuals to come to Malta by offering a personal tax of only 15%. That would be much more advantageous than the normal 35% or thereabouts. So that's one assistance. Another assistance that we can provide as also as a country and also as Malta Enterprise, those individuals that are looking for a work permit, a work visa to come and work in Malta, the country can has a 10-day parameter to give an answer on that work visa application. So that's, you know, where you stand with us. On another level, we can also help with skill development. So when you come for the effective training of your individuals, if you apply with Malta Enterprise and get the okay on that application and you're training your people, you can get back up to 70% of the costs of the training. So there are challenges, but there are ways how to go about them and around them. One way is also to go directly and address them through incentives that are supported by Malta Enterprise.
And one comment that I've been receiving so far throughout these two days of summits has been that the Maltese environment for blockchain and AI is quite sufficient and well supported. Given that, what do you think the next year or so holds for the blockchain companies in Malta?
Consolidation, I would say, because we need now to translate all the interest and the buzz around Malta into many more companies that are opening and many more that are almost there now. They're almost going to open in the next months and in this year. That's what I believe will happen. these companies have come to Malta in a number of events in the last year. They've seen Malta. They've been waiting for the VFA agents' licenses to be issued so that they can start applying to get their exchange or their wallet approved and licensed through Malta. So now they can effectively do it. They've been looking at the systems auditors being okayed by the MDIA. Now this is in place. We have three already in place and more will be approved. So companies that are bringing their technology and want a validation can get that validation through the systems auditors and through MDIA. So now there's no more excuses that the rule books haven't been written. They're in place. There's no more excuses that the effective system can't work because they were waiting for the VFA agents or the systems auditors. Now it is in place. We need to tackle the banking reality. We are conscious of it. We're not hiding it. We're not putting it under the carpet. We're discussing it, and hopefully we'll have solutions. Parliamentary Secretary Shkembri yesterday made it very clear that the MFSA is effectively looking at bank license applications as we speak. So in the next month, consolidation, quality, volume, but mostly and most importantly, quality.
Very interesting that you mentioned the banking issue. It is true, it's quite a prominent concern. But also, there is concern within the a way to sort of marry education and training to the sort of interest that is relevant here, evident here already. Do you have any comments on that?
The comments is that in a few months' time, the University of Malta has become a precursor in teaching in this industry. So from not being as prepared as one would hope, but I need to qualify this because the University of Malta has always been a very strong teaching university as well. So there were, you know, preambles to blockchain. Effectively now there are blockchain courses, master degrees in blockchain. There's MCAST as well that is offering part-time courses on blockchain in order to make it more mainstream and more understandable. So on the education front, we're pushing. I believe we will also be seeing a number of interesting projects in education and training coming from outside to Malta, be it from traditional institutions like prestigious universities, but also the education arms of the big blockchain players. You know that certain blockchain players have a lot of money to spend, and they are choosing to spend it in education. And obviously, sometimes education is twinned with recruitment of people for them from themselves as well, which makes a lot of sense. So watch the space also on education.
Thank you very much. Last of all, I'd like to ask what you've taken about from the summit so far. How do you feel the performance of the 2 days has been?
It's again been a very good summit, a very good event. So chapeau to Amman Police and all his team for doing a wonderful job in the venue, in the content, in marrying the startup village reality with the main floors. And I've always learned quite a lot from, because I'm a student of blockchain in the sense that I'm not a real technical individual. But what I learned, what gives me the best satisfaction, is to have time with clients that we would be already talking to throughout the year, have time to have a coffee, sit down, understand where they are progressing, what their challenges are, and finding the real ways, the tailor-made ways, how to assist them to achieve success.
So it's great to have heard your comments. Thank you very much for giving us your time.
Thank you for your time.